Anything else I can help you with?
Why do I waste my time? Why?
You okay, buddy?
Fantastic. You Americans are nothing but shysters and traitors and slippery tongue bull suckers. Here, help me, please. Bloody smile. No problem, Marco. You are the great genius, so we shove the hot poker up the ass. Say thank you, Marco. Thank you. Oh, thank you.
What are you, some kind of European toy maker?
No, I am a fucking genius with poker up the ass, like I say. Toy maker. Hello?
Do I look like I should entertain children?
No.
No, he says. No. I am the savior of the mankind, buddy.
Yes, you meet him.
Professor Marco Dragic. The one the silver-tongued American betrayed and not paid the money to. Yes, he told to shit, man.
So, what's this toy about?
It is not a toy, Big Nuts. It is demonstration of my genius, of my ideas about the source of life.
Oh, it's a toy boat.
Yes, it is a toy boat that I can power remotely using electricity in ways you cannot see.
Good for you. Ways I cannot see.
And still the investors will not come. Just a couple of old ladies and a moron.
Ladies, please.
Ladies! Gentlemen! Enchanté! Yes. Hello! Hello, sir! Okay, how is the piles? Yeah? Good, good, good. Okay, my friends, you are about to witness history. A demonstration of my infinite insight. All of us, we feel old. You are old. Oh. But maybe I can make you immortal. Using waves you cannot see. I will power this boat.
You're a goddamn fraud. And this buffoon dressed up like a buffoon is a stoolie. I watch them conspire, you morons.
I never met this buffoon before 2 minutes ago. Isn't that right?
Which part of it?
So, Professor, show us your magical toy boat. Only this time let the buffoon control it. Check if there's any funny business.
No, this ain't nothing to do with me.
Come, please, please. It is easy. Any moron could do it, and I am about to prove that. Here, take this, and this, and don't touch that. Use these ones to steer, and this one to shoot torpedoes, okay? Yes, now blow up the little battleships and avoid the sea mines. They have magnets attached. Make a nasty explosion if they touch the bottom. Okay! If this silly dimwit can use torpedoes on boats to destroy the battleships, imagine what technology can do in the hands of certified genius! And I have certificate. You see what he does? No wire like telegraph, no pulley system underwater, only waves in the air.
This is remarkable. Think of those poor boys on the H.L. Hunley. 8 of them perished to a mere 5 on the Housatonic. And what a way to go. Trapped in a box at the bottom of the bay. I suppose you intend to make an unmanned killing machine?
You misunderstand. This is the secret to life. Not death. The transmigration of the soul. I make lifeless metal breathe like man.
Well, I'm not sure about that.
Even little boats can sink, okay? Please!
That one's gone too.
You see what stupid man does? Torpedoes do not have so much range. I am an invisible wave engineer, not a rocket physicist. Be mindful of the danger.
I'm gone for you.
Yes, you see what he does? Now, bring the boat back to the dock.
That sure was something, but I'm not sure what, if anything, was proven here.
Let me just reload her.
This is really remarkable.
This is just a demonstration of my prowess, sir. The real miracles require investment. Now the dimwit will use invisible waves to destroy the little sailing boats before they get to other side of pond. Still avoiding magnetic mines.
Well, he'll attempt to, at least.
Shush! You're not here for this smart talk. The steam train, the telegraph machine, the motor car. They will all seem pedestrian in comparison to this technology. We are not reliant on wires or coal or gasoline. No, just rays in the air, like the voice of God.
And funding from us?
And funding from you, of course, but what thing to fund? What an opportunity! No one is stupid enough to pass this up. Not even Dimwit here.
Hey,
you really all work on your salesmanship.
A madness! All you think about is sales!
Look who rules the seas!
Very good, very good! Now bring in the boat back here. As I say, any fool, huh? Thank you, thank you.
What is that?
It is the stuff of life, sir.
It's incredible.
No, no, no. Incredible things are in my lab, back at Dover Hill. That will astound all of you. Mr. Marcel, can I count on your support?
Well, this is expensive.
It is immortality, sir. It is very cheap. Perhaps over lunch.
Maybe.
I'm gonna go.
Oh, yeah, of course. And thank you. If you're ever up near Dover Hill, pay me a visit. There, I will really amaze you. I hope you will forgive my European coarseness. In the Balkans, we are a member of people.
partner.
What's your damn problem?
Hey, partner. Look, I don't have that money on me. Come back and see you soon.
And I'll be here waiting.
Careful!
Okay then, girl. Hello, mister.
Hello, mister.
Hey, partner.
Well, howdy now.
Hey there.
Muevito.
Hey, mister. Hey there, partner.
Hello there.
What's wrong with you?
You know, when you have one of those days. Hi there, mister. Hey there, mister. Hey there.
Hello there.
Hi there, ma'am.
Hello.
Hey, partner. Hey, mister. How are you, ma'am?
Hello, sir.
Hola.
Hey there.
Excuse yourself.
Howdy, mister.
Where's the feller who was here last time I came in?
Oh, you probably mean my brother. Far away from here, I hope, not sullying my good name any further.
Howdy.
That's how a lawman solves a problem.
What the hell happened?
Just let the law handle this. Don't worry.
I do hope you're here to pay.
Who the hell do you think you are?
Okay, well, the price is fair. Here you go.
And here, sir, is your permit. Pending the usual formalities, of course, such as finding a suitable candidate for humane dispatchment.
I'll tell that to the professor.
Good luck.
Come on, girl.
Hey there, mister.
Come on, move it.
Hey there.
How do you do?
Hey, friend.
Will you move?
Hello.
Hey, folks. Hey, mister. Mister?
Hello there.
God damn it!
Watch yourself.
Say it for me.
Hey there, mister.
Órale, muévete!
Relax.
Está bien, pinche loco.
Hello, sir.
friend.
Hello, Professor... Professor...
Andrew Bell III.
That's it. So, the chief says you can test out your machine, pending the usual formalities.
And what are they?
Finding a suitable, subject.
Ah, funny you should mention. And this fella here, he seems sturdy enough, and he's guilty of sin.
Wilson J. McDaniels, wanted for murder, bigamy, and immoral animal husbandry. What's that?
The mind shudders. Ugh. Here, find him for me and help me put him out of his misery. This is all coming together wonderfully. The final piece of the puzzle. I have only a few more adjustments to make. Please hurry with our subject. Science awaits him. Off you go and fetch the man. His kindly and noble executioner awaits. He's a lucky man, this Mr. McDaniels. He'll have a place in... History books.
You all right, girl?
mister.
See the bind I'm in. I need help again. Come on. Okay, okay, fine. I know this doesn't look good, but I swear I didn't do nothing wrong.
You can't stay out of trouble, can you?
Just shoot the shackles. One bullet, that's all.
All right.
God,
second time's
yes.
The charm.
I can't believe it. Oh. I thought they were never coming off this time. Listen, buddy, I ain't got a red cent for you, and I feel terrible. But I did overhear something of interest. You know Ansburg? Well, some la-di-da rich folks bought up a little cabin up north of there. Very remote. You get me?
What? I look the type for all that, huh?
That's up to you, friend.
Yep.
Here, girl.
Business.
You fellas look busy.
We ain't selling candies, pal. Stay back or get shot.
Yeah. Get back.
Easy, girl. I got you.
I know, girl. Just give me a second. Okay, girl. Easy. Thank you.
stay.
You're your own jailkeeper, mister. In a prison of your own making.
Just hold still.
Jesus! Untie me now, you piece of shit! Son of a bitch!
Like sour grapes. You know, you ain't going to court. You ain't going to jail either. I'm taking you to a professor I know.
What in hell are you talking about?
Lucky man, mister. You get to be part of a great experiment.
Shut up!
Huh? You ain't gonna die needlessly, is what I mean. Nope. Your debt's gonna be an important step in the advancement of human knowledge.
What the hell you saying, mister?
This professor, Andrew Bell III, I believe he said. He's a little odd, maybe harebrained, but I got no reason to doubt the quality of his work.
What's this damn professor got to do with anything?
Well, he wants to try this new electricity chair on you. To kill you. Humane.
No!
Yeah. Well, he's gonna strap you into this contraption and run a large electric current through your system. Got something to do with moonshine. Don't quite know what. I guess that's why he's a professor and I'm the bounty catcher. Well, as I said, I can pass on his assurances that this is a most humane way to go. It'll be just like, well, like switching off a light.
They wouldn't let you do this to me. They wouldn't.
Oh, they would. And we got a permit and everything. You was in animal husbandry, am I right? Well, you ever seen lightning strike livestock, Mr. McDaniels? I ain't ever seen the actual impact, but I came across the pasture sometime after. The storm had just cleared, and there was smoke in the air, smell of burning hair.
No.
There must have been a dozen head of cattle lying there, piled up, mangled. Strange scars across their backs, legs, and necks. It's half like they was burned, and half like the skin was ripped off.
No.
Eyes bleeding. Some of them popped out.
No!
If I hadn't seen the storm, well, I would have thought some devil caused that mischief. But no, sir. It was lightning. Electricity does something, all right. I seen trees explode in front of me. I seen desert sand baked into glass. That's what I seen lightning do. But, you know, hey. This electricity professor's got a plan for you. Ah, that must be of an entirely different kind.
Thank you.
I'm sorry about that, McDaniels. You all right? Uh-huh. Yeah, me too. Well, you'll be happy to know we ain't got far to go. Hold on tight now. Here, I got him.
You're wonderful. Wait, just wonderful.
Come on. Don't be shy now. Let's go.
Oh, lay him over here.
Now, where's my money?
Money?
Yeah, for all the running around I've been doing.
Oh, well, once they buy my humane electric ending facilitator, there'll be money enough for you, sir.
Yeah, let's hope.
All right, let's get our poor unfortunate ready for the demonstration. Oh, do come and watch. It'll be amazing. Come along.
Well?
Yeah, well, anyway.
Excuse me, partner.
Morning!
You, mister, excuse me.
Hello. Seen better days, I'll tell you.
Hey, move it!
On it, mister. Thank you.
right here, girl. Mister?
Bonjour, monsieur.
You know when you have one of those days?
Are we?
Anyway, onwards and upwards.
Au revoir.
Enjoy the show, if that's possible. It's a free show, so don't...
What's this show, then?
Mr. Charles Chatternay. Go and see for yourself, but don't blame me.
I just don't like how much time you're spending with the man, is all.
Just wait until you see his work. It's very progressive.
Well, I'm not so very sure how I feel about progression, paintings or otherwise.
Come on. You won't have seen the like of it before, I promise.
Maybe that's a good thing. Hold on. Let me compose myself.
Mister?
We'll miss the party.
Hello.
I think that it's Greek.
Morning to
you. Or could be Roman.
How's things? Hello, ma'am.
That's far too modern for my tastes.
Morning, mister.
Mr. Chardonnay, he's just a terror. It's making me blush.
The man simply can't paint.
Look at these idiots.
Excuse me, Mr. Chatternay. Couldn't you have painted some drawers on her?
Madame, I paint her in her natural state, as she was and will be in paradise.
There's nothing natural about that.
Clothes are civilization, repression, death. To be naked is to be free, innocent, alive. Like Buddha said, you know, we are all just here to fuck.
Well, that explains the decadence of those Hottentots.
Hey, you got a picture of my wife here, in her... delicate!
Henry, is that your behind? Why would you be showing it to that man?
That's my mama. As nude as the day she was born.
Stop looking at my husband's buttocks.
Stop looking at my mama.
Well, maybe she shouldn't expose herself like that.
This is disgusting.
The nerve on you!
That's it!
Oh, come on, Mildred. This is no place for us.
Come here, son of a bitch!
You filthy little man! Oh!
Hey, I'm coming after you, Frenchie!
Hey.
All right!
is well and truly over. Let's get out of here. Come on, I know a place where I can disappear for a few days. Come along. This way, come on. I think we are okay. The exhibition, what can you say? It was not boring, huh?
That it was not.
Art should test people, push them. I thought I was a fraud, a no-talent brush washer. Now I'm not sure. We provoke emotions, no?
You keep provoking emotions like that, and all your canvases will have punch holes through.
I told you I was a whole ass!
You did, and you are. Now maybe go be an asshole somewhere else for a while.
Ah, here we are. I know a lady over here. She may let me stay for a while.
Good luck.
That picture I gave you, it will be worth something someday. I can feel it.
Perhaps. Right now, seems like the only thing it'd get me is kicking the balls.
Oh, you are funny, you know. I hope to see you again sometime. My angel, my little bird, it's me!
Hello, mister.
How you doing?
Madam?
Hello.
something about that.
Comunque.
Out here, friend.
Hey, mister.
So, you hungry, huh? I got food. I got food inside. Come along. What you thinking, partner?
Yep. Yep.
Yeah, move.
Don't seem overly humane to me.
I think it's mighty fine.
Help!
Shite!
Someone help!
Could I please get some assistance?
No, no! Definitely. This can't be real!
Not good.